October 19th, 1987, a day that would come to be known as Black Monday.
In the midst of economic turmoil, alarm bells are ringing louder than ever. Despite efforts to contain it, inflation persists, squeezing budgets and rattling markets. Uncertainty looms over job security as revisions reveal a less rosy picture of employment gains. The once promising gig economy now faces imminent collapse, threatening the financial stability of millions. And as if these weren't enough, the banking sector stares down the barrel of potential disaster, with bank failures looming. The February 2023 Consumer Price Index report is anticipated to reveal a resurgence in inflation, primarily driven by a rise in gasoline prices. Despite excluding the impact of elevated fuel costs, the report is projected to indicate persistent upward pressure on prices, which may be more enduring than desired by Federal Reserve officials. Following significant progress in 2023, recent data suggesting persistent price and wage pressures has left investors questioning whether the momentum in inflation reduction is faltering. These concerns have led markets to significantly revise their expectations for the timing of the Federal Reserve's next policy adjustment, shifting the anticipated commencement from March to June. According to consensus estimates from FactSet, economists anticipate a 0.4% monthly increase in the overall CPI for February, up from January's 0.3% growth, while the annual growth rate is expected to remain steady at 3.1%. During recent testimony before Congress, Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell reiterated the central bank's stance that it remains uncertain whether inflation is nearing its target. Given that the core CPI is projected to maintain an annualized pace of 3.9% over the 3 months leading up to February, the Fed is likely to seek further assurance that inflation is progressing toward its target consistently over a sustained period. Core CPI has been sticky over the past year. Now, expert analysts are saying another Black Monday is here. October 19, 1987, marked the darkest day in Wall Street's history as global stock markets crashed. This catastrophic event witnessed the largest single-day percentage decline in the U.S. stock market. The Dow Jones Industrial Average plummeted by over 22%, while the S&P 500 Index suffered a comparable drop of 20.4%. To grasp the magnitude of Black Monday, consider that the most severe one-day decline during the 1929 stock market crash was just over 12%, significantly less than half of the plunge experienced in 1987. The impact wasn't confined to the DJIA alone, the National Association of Securities Dealers. Automated quotations also recorded its all-time record one-day loss of 11.35%, with a slow recovery process. Additionally, the S&P 500 saw a staggering 30% decline, losing 58 points. The turmoil extended beyond the U.S. borders, with markets in Australia, Hong Kong, Singapore, and Mexico witnessing significant downturns. Globally, stock market values were in freefall. Within a single day, over $500 billion vanished from the Dow Jones Index. The inundation of phone calls from concerned individuals attempting to contact their brokers further highlighted the magnitude of the crisis, leaving millions in instant financial turmoil. This Monday, the BTFP is coming to an end, and the gig economy will be haunted down. The signs are obvious, and strategic moves from billionaires and CEOs tell us that they know much more than we do. Warren Buffett, the billionaire investor who famously said that the best holding period for a stock is forever, sold $13 billion in stock in the second quarter of last year while buying less than $5 billion. Similarly, Jeff Bezos, Leon Black, Jamie Dimon, the Walton family, and Meta CEO Mark Zuckerberg have collectively unloaded billions in company stock. Fortune is calling it the Great Cash Out. These transactions, occurring within weeks of each other, serve as a clear indicator of impending trouble ahead. Meanwhile, the income of Americans is about to take a massive hit. The Labor Department has significantly revised down the previously reported robust payroll gains in both December and January. In January, the department slashed 124,000 jobs from the initially reported 353,000 gains, resulting in a revised total of just 229,000. Similarly, for December, it reduced 43,000 from the total non-farm payroll employment, revising the gain to 290,000 from 333,000. Consequently, the combined gain in non-farm employment for December and January is now 167,000 lower than previously reported. many Americans are grappling with unemployment and financial strain, a reality reflected in the credit card data. According to reports from the Federal Reserve Bank of New York and TransUnion, Americans collectively owe $1.13 trillion on their credit cards, marking a 10% increase from a year earlier. The average balance per consumer has soared to $6,360, setting a historic record. Moreover, households are exhibiting signs of financial pressure, with more cardholders carrying debt from month to month or falling behind on payments. Both the New York Fed and TransUnion note significant jumps in credit card delinquency rates, with the New York Fed reporting a surge of over 50% in 2023 alone. TransUnion's research indicates that serious delinquencies, those 90 days or more past due, have reached the highest level since 2009. According to a recent survey by Bankrate, over one-third, 36% of U.S. adults find themselves burdened with more credit card debt than emergency savings, marking the highest percentage since 2011. This trend highlights a concerning financial vulnerability among a significant portion of the population. Furthermore, Bankrate's findings reveal that nearly 1 in 4, 22% U.S. adults, lack any emergency savings whatsoever, representing the second lowest percentage recorded in 13 years of polling. Alarmingly, less than half of Americans, 44%, feel confident in their ability to cover a $1,000 emergency expense from their savings. This indicates a widespread reliance on credit and limited financial preparedness for unforeseen circumstances. For many Americans, living paycheck to paycheck has become commonplace. To cope with the increasing cost of living, a considerable number have turned to side hustles, with nearly half of respondents reporting engagement in additional work outside of their primary occupation. This translates to approximately 39% of working Americans, that is, as many as 80 million individuals. As expenses continue to rise, side hustles have become essential for many to meet their financial obligations. Among Gen Zers and millennials engaged in side hustles, a staggering 80% claim that the current economic landscape has heightened their dependence on this supplementary income. In fact, 52% of them rely on this income to cover primary expenses or bills. However, despite the reliance on side hustles, only 21% of young side hustlers express confidence in their ability to manage their financial obligations if their additional source of income were to disappear suddenly. Now, all of that is about to change. The Internal Revenue Service is closely monitoring the gig economy due to its significant growth. With more Americans engaging in gig work and side hustles, there's a greater responsibility for individuals to manage their earnings and fulfill tax obligations independently without the aid of employer payroll systems. Recognizing this trend, the IRS has issued a reminder emphasizing the importance of reporting all income derived from gig work, service industry endeavors, digital platforms, and foreign sources. Recent data from the IRS reveals that Americans collectively failed to pay $688 billion in taxes on their 2021 returns, marking a record high. In response, the agency has initiated urgent measures to enhance compliance, including increased scrutiny of individuals earning income through the gig economy. As part of its efforts to bolster tax enforcement, the IRS intends to recruit nearly 30,000 new employees and implement advanced technology over the next 2 years. This initiative is supported by an investment plan of $80 billion aimed at improving tax enforcement capabilities. As outlined in its strategic operating plan, the IRS plans to allocate approximately $8.64 billion of the new funding during the 2023 and 2024 fiscal years, with a focus on hiring 8,782 enforcement staff members. U.S. Deputy Treasury Secretary Wally Adeyemo highlighted the IRS's commitment to enhancing enforcement efforts, noting a significant emphasis on recruiting data scientists. These professionals will work alongside traditional tax attorneys and revenue agents, leveraging advanced data analytics technology to identify potential audit targets more effectively. It appears that Americans are about to have it harder, but the banking sector is on the edge of ruin as well. The Federal Reserve's bank bailout program, initiated in response to the banking crisis last spring, is set to conclude on March 11th. Following the collapse of Silicon Valley Bank and Signature Bank in March last year, the Federal Reserve introduced the Bank Term Funding Program. This initiative helped to facilitate easy access to cash for banks, ensuring their ability to meet the demands of depositors during a time of financial instability. As the program nears its end, the question of whether banks still require assistance remains unanswered. With its closure, banks may encounter heightened difficulties in securing affordable funding. This could result in increased borrowing costs, reduced lending capacity, and potentially hindered economic growth. Moreover, the looming possibility of a recession in 2024, as predicted by many, adds further concern. Furthermore, banks are grappling with significant challenges in the commercial real estate sector. Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell anticipates that the weaknesses in commercial real estate may lead to the closure or merger of more small banks. Although Powell believes the situation is manageable, the reality may suggest otherwise. In a recent 60 Minutes interview, Powell acknowledged the likelihood of some smaller banks needing to be closed or merged out of existence due to losses from declining property values across the United States. Factors such as the Federal Reserve's elevated interest rates and the lingering effects of the pandemic, which have led to vacancies in many city center buildings, have worsened the challenges faced by banks in the commercial real estate market. Powell said, "There are some smaller and regional banks that have concentrated exposures in these areas that are challenged. Regional banks face heightened vulnerability due to their significant exposure to commercial real estate properties compared to larger competitors. While commercial real estate loans make up only 13% of total credit for banks with assets exceeding $100 billion, they constitute 44% of total bank credit for smaller banks." The International Monetary Fund has issued a warning about an impending crisis. 1 year following the collapse of Silicon Valley Bank, the IMF has cautioned that continued exposure to risk among U.S. lenders could precipitate a fresh financial crisis. Its report specifically noted the vulnerability of a weak tail of banks due to their exposure to high interest rates. It's crucial to note that Silicon Valley Bank and other failed banks had an exceptionally high concentration of commercial real estate exposures. Indeed, the warning signs are clear. The Great Crash has begun, and Black Monday may be worse than we dare to imagine.